Hello, firearms friends. Joel Colander here for Rock Island Auction Company. And didn't we just do these videos for May? And the answer is yes. It was just a couple weeks ago we did a series of these videos for our May premiere auction. Series of videos where we show you something coming up on the next day of auction, because you can place bids right up until the last minute. So we like to show you something coming up on the next day, so you have plenty of time to plan. Like I said, we just did these for our May premiere auction. Record-setting sale, of course, 30 million. Biggest firearms auction ever held. And if you were watching and paying attention, you know some of the names that came out of there, and I'm mentioning them for a reason. So we have collections that we've been selling for a while, like the Malcolm King collection of fine sporting arms. See some big bore hunting rifles, some fine shotguns, things of that nature. We have the Gerald Klaas collection of Smith & Wesson's, primarily a Smith & Wesson and very accomplished Smith & Wesson collector. We have the Clive Cussler collection, and a lot of you might be familiar with Clive Cussler from his Dirk Pitt series of novels. He's been writing literally for decades, and he was quite an accomplished firearms collector as well. And we also have, perhaps my favorite, I may be a bit biased, the Dr. Robert Azar collection. Dr. Azar's collection, what was highlighted in our last auction, are just outstanding Colt semi-autos. They're absolutely incredible. Accomplished doesn't even describe it. But he's not just a collector of Colt early semi-autos. In fact, he's in several genres. He had wide-ranging interests of guns that appeal to numerous genres of collectors. So the good news is, and those are in our premier auction, here we have the June 10th through 12th premier firearms auction. It's Thursday through Saturday. And not every firearm that's in these creme de la creme collections, not every firearm can be a six-figure firearm. People have things in their collections, of course, that are high value, low value, some in between. And some of those things that aren't at the top value, these world-class collectible firearms that are in our premier firearms auctions, you will find in our sporting and collector firearms auction. And that's what I have today, is a handful of the firearms from the Dr. Robert Azar collection. Now, I'm going to make a grouping and a category, if you will, and put it up on our website. There's a couple hundred items of Dr. Azar's in here, from Lugers, Colt Single Action Armies, a wide variety of 1911s, pre-64 Winchester Model 70s. I mean, you name it. It's pretty endless. And if there's generally a gun that's popular, like a pre-64 Model 70 Single Action Army 1911, he probably liked those too, and has some. And you can find them in the June Sporting Collector Auction. So here are five that I picked out that are going to be sold on day one, just to show you. Now, these are just day one. There's plenty of other collections, plenty of other items from the Dr. Robert Azar collection on days two and three. So head over to our website and you can find them. So starting to my right, let's take a look at these Colt Single Action Armies. First and foremost, we have a beautiful Colt Cavalry Single Action Army shipped by its factory letter in 1885. Now, that in and of itself would be pretty darn impressive. This one also happens to be a David F. Clark sub-inspected version. So if you know Colt collectors and single action armies, once you get into those sub-inspectors, you're really into it. You're really into Colt collecting at that point. And Clark is, of course, one of those desirable sub-inspectors. Perhaps beaten only by this one, this is an Ainsworth inspected Colt Cavalry Single Action Army. And it's not just Ainsworth inspected, but you hear Ainsworth, and if you're a Colt collector, you know, oh, that's pretty early on in some of the Colts. So this three-digit Ainsworth inspected Colt Single Action Army also comes with a COPEC letter, really going down the details of this gun. So you have two pretty desirable Colt Single Action Armies. And if they're, dare I say, if they're good enough for Dr. Azar's collection, they're good enough for yours as well. Moving into the next century, to my left, a trio of 1911s. Now, I have this one facing the opposite direction, so we can see all these fantastic models. This is actually a Brazilian contract government model, and you can see with these, we have a crest here, and I'm going to give this the Lieutenant Aldo Rain treatment, since I don't speak Portuguese, and say it's an Exercito Brasileiro right here on the side. And again, from the Dr. Azar collection, you don't have to, not worry about affording these because they're in a premier auction. Here they are. For one of the most accomplished Colt collections we've had come through our doors, and you can add them in your collection as well. Right next to this, I picked it out just because it's a gorgeous Rem UMC 1911. In fact, that's a four-digit serial number. Pretty attractive option to be finding in a sporting collector auction. It's also representative of several in his collection, whether you want Rem UMC, Union Switch and Signal, just regular Colt 1911s. We got them, and they're from the Azar collection. And last but not least, one that definitely caught my attention when I saw it going through, Colt government model, 1911. This happens to be government model, if we flip it around here, C68. So you're talking a two-digit production Colt government model. That's 1912 production, according to the Colt serial number lookup on their website. Now, we've sold some two-digit government models before and some three-digit government models as well in our Premier Firearms auction. And let me tell you, to have one in a sporting collector auction is a phenomenal opportunity for someone who wants to own a two-digit government model but doesn't want to break the bank, or if you're like me, you don't have a bank to break. Just fantastic opportunities. Like I said, they're if these are good enough for Dr. Azar's collection, I guarantee it they're good enough for mine. Again, these are all on day one. Make sure you subscribe. We'll have two more videos coming up, each one showing something on the next day of auction. Thanks for watching, everybody. Until next time, keep that powder dry.